Hello everyone, welcome to Aurora's Diary and welcome to 90 Days of Bible Study. Today we'll be looking at Psalm 1. I just had this strong feeling in my heart that we should look at Psalm 1. So we'll be reading Psalm 1 and then we'll be studying God's Word to what from there. Psalm 1 says, "Blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the river of waters. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season. Its leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever it does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the day in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish." The Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. I'm just going to quickly put that up. We're looking at Psalm 1, from verse 1 to 6. So today we're looking at Psalm 1 from verse 1 to 6. Psalm 1 from verse 1 to 6. The Bible says that blessed is the man. Blessed is man. Blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly. Blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. His delight is in the law of the Lord. Hallelujah. Said, blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. And in his law does he meditate day and night. We can say, how can you be blessed? How can you be blessed? If we're going to say, oh, let's look at the topic for this scripture, it's how to be blessed. Praise God. How to be blessed. The first thing says that he does not walk in the counsel of the ungodly. So the first criteria for a man to be blessed is not to walk in the counsel of the ungodly. Right? It is not to walk in the counsel of the ungodly. Are you a man, a woman, a boy, a girl, a youth out there seeking to be blessed? You should not walk in the counsel of the ungodly. What does this mean? To walk in the counsel of the ungodly simply is to walk in the counsel that does not glorify God. That is to walk in the with the advice or with the reasoning or in the reasoning that does not please God, the ungodly reasoning. I'll give a quick example from the scriptures. Of Solomon. When David handed down the kingdom to Solomon, and Solomon was handing down the kingdom to, I think it's Rehoboam, and then he was asked a question by the people, you know, and he had to respond when he was questioned. And he was asked So would you lighten our burdens? You know, we have so much, we pay in taxes and all that. And you know, the elderly gave him an advice. And then the young people, his own age mates, also gave him an advice. And it's just like taking two different advices and weighing it, two different counsels, if you put it that way, and weighing it against each other. The young people gave him what we would call today an ungodly counsel. An ungodly counsel to speak harshly to the people. You know, that's like ungodly, to be rude. That's an ungodly counsel. That, oh, when you get there, be very rude to them. Just tell them, you know what, my father ruled you with an iron hand. If you think he did with an iron hand, I'm going to be more terrible than my father. My reign is going to be more fierce. And he took that counsel against the one that said he should be subtle with the people and make them feel, oh, he's going to make their burdens lighter. And guess what? Because of the wrong counsel that he took, he was not able to keep the kingdom that was handed down to him. So when we talk about godly counsel, we're talking about counsel that brings glory to the name of the Lord. When people advise you, when people counsel you, how do you take it? Do you weigh it against the word of God, or do you just take it hook, line, and sinker? Do you weigh the counsel of men against the word of God? Or do you just believe that, no, this counsel is okay, and then you just go ahead and then you do it? So today the Bible is talking about not taking the counsel of the ungodly. That means we can have godly counsel and we can have ungodly counsel. You can have people advise you and direct you in a godly manner, in a way that pleases God and glorifies the name of God. And you can have people direct you in a way that takes you away from the will of God. So you have to choose how you respond. Do you want to take the counsel of the ungodly? Do you want to sit in the seat of discomfort? This is, blessed is the man that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the way of sinners. He does not stand in the way of sinners. That means he doesn't stay where things that are not pleasing to God is being carried out. He doesn't stand in the way of sinners. So, for example, the Bible admonishes us not to fornicate. And then you say you are a child of God, you are blessed. And then you walk, you mix, you mingle. And then with people, they're always talking about, oh, how they fornicate and the things that they know and how much joy or whatever they derive from it and all that. When you keep sitting in that kind of place, it is called, or when you keep standing in that kind of place or sitting with those kind of people, then we can say that you stand in the way of sinners. Because if you do not guard your heart, you will fall in the same way that those people are falling. You will do those same things that these people are doing, because you keep being in their midst and you keep experiencing what they experience, either like practically or because of the words that they speak. And as a result, if you do not take time, you actually start doing the things that they do, so that maybe you can also have contributions to their conversations. And that is what is called standing in the way of sinners. So by the time you keep standing there listening to all the things that they say, you know, before you know it, you start wanting to experience the things that they experience. And that way you do not guard your heart. And then you become like them. So the Bible is saying today we should guard against that, standing in the way of sinners. And the Bible also says that he does not sit in the seat of the scornful. So he doesn't sit in the seat of the scornful. So when people that scorn others, when people that are scornful sit, it doesn't sit there. You don't sit down with people that talk down. You don't sit with people that make evil talks about other people, that scorn other people, that mock other people. You do not sit with them. So you do not sit with the scornful. You do not stand in the way of sinners. That is part of the ways to be blessed. You do not walk in the wrong counsel. That is part of the ways to be blessed. And it says in verse 2, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in it doth he meditate day and night. His delight is in the law of the Lord. What is your delight? What do you delight in? Do you study the word of God? Do you meditate on it day and night? Bible says that when your delight is in the law of the Lord and you meditate in it day and night, that means you pick the word of God and then you turn it over. My pastor will say you chew it, you turn it over in your heart, you turn it over, you keep going over it in your heart. You meditate upon it. How can I achieve this? The scripture says that we should do this. How can I become like this? You know, you take that word. For example, a word that is applicable to your situation, you take the word and you keep turning it over in your heart. Maybe there is a word that comes to you from the word of God, from your study, and you take that word and you begin to turn it around in your heart. You meditate in the word, you delight in the word. This is delight is in the law of the Lord, and in it does he meditate day and night. This is it shall be. That is like saying it's this thing would happen if you do this. That means it's like a dependent variable. When you do this shall be. So it's like cause and effect. If you meditate on the word of the Lord day and night, we come here every day, we study the word of God together. You meditate on the word of the Lord. We take it beyond the Bible study time, and then we go ahead and still turn it over in our heart day and night. Day and night. We meditate on the word of God. We delight in the word of God. Day and night. Bible says, you shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Praise God. Psalm 1 and verse 3 now. Says, and it shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. So if you delight in the law of the Lord and you meditate in it day and night, that is the cause. And this will be the effect. You shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in season. Hallelujah. You will bring forth your fruit in season. You will bring forth your fruit in season. Praise God. And its leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever it does shall prosper. Its leaves shall not wither, and whatsoever he does shall prosper. Praise the Lord. Its leaves shall not wither. So God is saying, when you meditate in the law of the Lord day and night, when you delight in the law of the Lord and you meditate therein day and night, these things shall be. Now we're going to look at what does it mean to be planted by the rivers of water. What does it mean to be planted by the rivers of water? That means that you always have connection with the source. You are not planted by the lake. You are not planted by the pond that gets water, you know, seasonally. Maybe when it's raining, then the lake is overflowing. And if it's planted by the pond, that means that when it rains, the pond gets water. Then during the dry season, then there might be drought. No, by the rivers, the river the river that flows with water is the source that supplies all other streams that you see and that overflows into the pond when it's really heavily raining and supplies the lakes. By the river, the tree shall be planted by the rivers of water. And it will bring the fruit, its fruit in season. Now, if somebody is constantly getting supplies, definitely that person will be productive. So if you constantly are by the waters, you are constantly being watered, you will bring forth your fruit in season. It means that at the time when that thing is needed, you will bring that for that fruit. When love is needed, when you need to speak in love, that love would come out from within your being. Why? Because you are bringing forth your fruit in season. Praise God. So the word of God is saying, when you meditate in the law of the Lord day and night, when you do not sit in the seat of the scornful, you do not stand in the way of sinners, you do not take the ungodly counsel, you will be like that tree planted by planted by the rivers of water, and you will bring forth your fruit in season. And the Bible says rivers of water. That means your source is diverse. You are constantly having the supply. And because of that, you are productive in season. You bring forth your fruit in season. Mankataya lambadaya. You bring forth your fruit in season. Mankataya lambadaya. In season. Not out of season. Not stunted growth. Nothing delaying it. In season. In season, at the right time, the fruit comes forth in the name of Jesus. At the right time, just as the word has said, and your leaves shall not wither, whatsoever you do shall prosper, because you are getting it from the source, the rivers of water. That is your source. So it means that you are getting it continually. Praise God. You are getting it continually. There is nothing stopping the flow. Because it is not just one river, it is the rivers of water. So you are getting what you're supposed to get in season. And that is why your leaves will not wither. Are you worried that this thing will happen? Some people say, you live long and then you don't witness evil. That is the palace of the world. You are in the household of God. God has given you his words. And he says your leaves will not wither. Are you worried about your children? They will not go before you. Your leaves will not wither. Your fruit will not die in your lifetime, in your presence. They will not wither. And he says, whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Because this person is coming from the source. He's going to bring forth good fruits. Whatsoever I do shall prosper. It is the word of God. Whatsoever he does shall prosper, because this is the word of God. And remember, God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. When he gives his word, it shall come to pass. What do you need to do to be blessed? Meditate in the law of the Lord day and night. Forsake the seat of the scornful. Do not sit down where people, you know, criticize and mock other people. Do not stand in the way of sinners when they talk about how they cheat on their husbands and make money. You just walk away. When people start talking rubbish, how they cheat on their wives and it's very fun, you just walk away. You do not stand there and listen to the wrong information. You guard your heart. When people talk about how they derive pleasure from doing the wrong things, once they open their mouth, you just walk away. Why? Because the Bible says you do not stand in the way of sinners. Praise God. He says, you don't walk in the counsel of the ungodly. When somebody gives you the wrong counsel, you will know. And some someone is asking me, how do I know that this is the wrong counsel? You wait against the word of the Lord. What is God saying about this? What is right if I weigh this according to the word? If Rehoboam had done that in the scriptures, when the elders gave him a
And the elders gave him the counsel, and the young people gave him the counsel, he would have known that a soft word would yield a better result than harsh words, and he would have kept the kingdom that was handed over to him. So when you get the wrong counsel, you will know. So the Bible talks about not taking the wrong counsel. So when we do these things, you will be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. You will bring forth your fruit in season. Your leaves will not wither, and whatsoever you do shall prosper. It is law. It is the word of God, and it is so. Hallelujah. So when we do these things, we shall be productive, consistently productive, and then we have no fear. When you stay by the source, you get inspiration and direction from the source, which is the word of God. So because you're getting inspired from this source, where you meditate day and night, you get inspirations, and then you begin to do things based on the inspiration of the word of God, then you will begin to prosper. Praise the Lord. It says in verse 4 that the ungodly are not so, but are like the shaft which the wind drives away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. Praise God. This alludes to the same thing. The ungodly are like the shaft which the wind drives away. Sometimes when you look at the shaft, it appears very fine, very fine, very smooth and all that. But when the wind comes, it takes it away. And sometimes when you look at the life of other people and it looks like, oh, he's so good, he's so beautiful. But when situations arises and storms arise, it just blows it away. Then you realize, oh, that is shaft. So you are not, and that is why it says the sinners will not stand in the congregation of the righteous, because the righteous are firmly planted. They are firmly rooted. If you look at the trees that are planted by the rivers of water, they have deep roots, because they are standing firm. They have to, you know, put their roots deep, so they are not just on the surface. Praise the Lord. It says the Lord knows the way of the righteous, and that is what happens when you stay in the place of constant supply. When you meditate in the law of the Lord day and night, you are always in line, in sync with the ways of God. So God knows your ways. God knows your ways. God directs you. God leads you. Praise God. I'm so happy today for this word of God. This is the way of the ungodly shall perish. Father, we thank you because we are not ungodly. We thank you because today we have the will, the grace, and the divine direction not to walk in the counsel of the ungodly, not to stand in the way of sinners, not to sit in the seat of the scornful. Today we receive divine grace and ability to delight in the law of the Lord and to meditate in it day and night. And because of this, we are like the trees that are planted by the rivers of water. We bring forth our fruit in season. Our leaves do not wither. And everything we put our hands upon to do prospers. Everything we put our hands upon to do, to lay our hands upon to do, prospers. Because we study the word of God. We meditate in it day and night. And it becomes our reality. Father, we just give you praise. We thank you for your word today. Thank you for your word that has come to us in season, and we are blessed by it. Hallelujah. Father, we give you praise. We just want to say thank you. We give you all the glory, all the honor and adoration, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise God. If you're listening to this live broadcast and you get to give your life to Christ, and you're looking at yourself and saying, I want to be like this, I want to bring forth my fruit and seeding, I want everything I do to prosper, I want to be that man that God is talking about, that is continuously watered, I just want you to say this prayer with me. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for the sacrifice you made on the cross of Calvary. I accept everything that comes with this sacrifice. I repent today of my sins. I acknowledge that I am a sinner. I repent of my sins. And I ask you to have mercy and forgive me. Today I begin, from today henceforth, I begin to walk in the finished work of Christ. I begin to walk in the liberty that you have given unto me. I declare that I am born again, because today I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Because today I take you as my Lord and Savior. I accept you into my life. I give it all to you. I lay it down at your feet. From today henceforth, I declare that I am a child of God. I am born again. And from today henceforth, I begin to walk in the right counsel. Father, I thank you. Thank you for your word. Thank you for the life that I have received today. Thank you because I am born again. For in Jesus' name, I have prayed. Amen. If you just said the prayer, congratulations, you are not born again. The life of God is now in you. And the nature of sin has been destroyed. Hallelujah. Continue to meditate in the word of the Lord. You can download the Bible app. Study the word of God daily. Join Bible studies. Look for a Bible believing church and start attending. Start practicing what the scripture says. And your life will never remain the same. I commit you into the hands of God. And I ask that the Spirit of God will breathe on you. And that your life will never remain the same again. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. We're still going to complete the study of the book of Romans. But for now, we're putting that on hold as the Spirit directs us. And tomorrow, we're going to be talking about revival. Praise God. We're going to be talking about revival. So, during the course of the day, I'm going to drop the scripture. So we're going to look at for tomorrow, and I pray and believe and trust that God will revive us again, and our lives will never be the same. We'll continue to go better and get better in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much for coming online today. Thank you for joining these 90 days of Bible study. I believe today is day 11. I pray that God will give us the grace to continue in his word in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for joining. Bye-bye.